Hello again, peeps. Welcome back to the video series. You don't need no stinking realtor to sell your house. Your host, Justin Dower, Spectrum Real Estate Consultants, Keller Williams Real Estate in Northern Rhode Island. Today we are doing episode 2 on segment 1. Segment 1 being about pricing your home. Episode 2 here is regarding assessing the unique features of your house and trying to understand the value or lack thereof from the perspective of the widest buying audience possible. Now, we do that because we want all buyers to be interested in your home, or you do, you're the realtor in this case. The more folks you have interested in your home, the more folks you have offering on your home, and the more offers you can leverage against one another to ultimately make the highest sales price and the best, smoothest sale. So, we can take stock of what we know from like television and life in general. We've all seen million-dollar listing. What is the number one factor in a human being's perception of value and desirability of a home? It's wow factor. It's beauty, guys. We're all built. Our animal selves are built by eons of evolution to recognize beauty in the world, and that's what we're going for. A well-maintained home is very obvious. Pride in ownership and somebody who really goes out of their way to make sure that maintenance is not deferred and that everything's taken care of, those are the homes that are most well-received in any market, frankly. And it's easy to understand why. Nobody wants to inherit somebody else's problems. And when you walk into a home, your first impression of it, hopefully, is, you know, wow, this place really looks beautiful. It's cleanly, it's tidy, it's not deteriorating. Certain maintenance items that are very important for the longevity of the home have been taken into account, like the age of the roof, the age of the windows, the age of the infrastructure, heating system, structural elements. This sort of stuff is very obvious. You know, you go downstairs and, you know, one of the main lolly columns is a screw jack and is rusted at the bottom and isn't set into a concrete footing. You're a little bit worried, especially if it's an older home. You know, looking at that roof and it's covered in organics and, you know, clearly is slumping in the gable. You get the idea. You know, you don't want to, unless this is the purpose of your purchase, is to gain some sweat equity and to do some work. The large majority of buyers, especially today, which is, you know, the topic is pricing your house in today's market, really would like to see something with most everything taken care of, because we all know after the supply problems and supply chain problems of the CVID, post-CVID era, work and materials and even finding labor to do the work in the first place, very difficult, very, very expensive. So better that you are kind of amortizing the cost of all those maintenance items over the lifespan of your tenure as an owner there, rather than having to do them all yourself out of the gate, especially seeing as, you know, lots of folks out there aren't handy. And, you know, maybe don't have even the time to manage your construction process and things like this. Now, let's get a little bit more particular on some items that people feel are a good thing. And sometimes they are. Let's talk about swimming pools. You know, very attractive to walk out that back door and see the huge party patio with the pavers and the built-in grill and the huge in-ground swimming pool. And while impressive, they are not for every market segment. Pools in general are a danger. You know, unless you are of able body and your children, if you have them, are also of an age that they can keep themselves alive around swimming pools without supervision, they can be a danger. You know, same is true of older folks. Either they're not going to get used because, you know, a person is of an age that it's really not so easy for them to get in and out. Or even if they are able to use it, the maintenance of it, you know, it's a cost. Not only in maintaining the pool, its cleanliness, opening and closing it, but also the insurance costs. Most places, if you've got a pool at all, you also have to have a fence so other people around your neighborhood can't wander in there, dogs, you know, other pets, people's children. Fall in and drown. So, you know, pools are a gift and a curse. If your home is such that it lends itself to a specific subset of buyers that would really like to see that pool, then, you know, maybe it's a detraction, not an attraction. And you need to weight it as such when you are considering its value in pricing a property. Similarly, and you know, kind of similar concerns with danger anyhow, are open staircases. You know, very nice aesthetically for a certain subject subset of buyers. But those buyers with young kids, you know, it can be a danger. Pets, similarly, you know, the dogs don't like going up and down those staircases that they can see through the stairs. And I, you know, small concerns, but people take great pride in work that they've done in their home, the way their homes have been set up, and it can be very easily, it can be very easy to incorrectly add value to a home because of this or that particular design element where it's not going to be received as such by the rest of the market. You know, for those handy homeowners out there who have really gone bananas with every last single upgrade in terms of using the best galvanized screws on the deck and, you know, lag bolts, this, and, you know, my drainage runs out 40 feet to the back of the hill and out. You know, the market just wants to know the deck isn't going to fall down and that the basement's not full of water. So while you will appeal in detailing those items to a certain subset of buyers, again, it's not for everybody. Not everybody cares as much as you may about these sorts of elements. Now, we talked about beauty. You can have a well-maintained, good-looking, cared-for home with an older aesthetic that will still be well received by the market. But we all know that most people would rather have a brand spanking new kitchen, brand spanking new bathroom. There is a premium for a toilet that's never seen a butt. You know, if you just replaced it and now you're selling this home with a brand new toilet, maybe you get a premium for that out there in the market. Suffice it to say that you should, as a homeowner who automatically has a bias that their home is the best and everything about it is the best, probably do a little bit of bouncing information off of some other folks that you may have in your circles, or you know, you can come to a real estate professional and we'll kind of give you the lowdown on what the market really wants to see and what it doesn't. What parts of your home may be very positive and what may not. We could go on for hours about, you know, internet service providers and you know, what type of roofing shingles and siding and what things you would expect to see a return on your investment immediately. Let's say if you wanted to take down that clapboard that, you know, even though it's not deteriorating, isn't in the same longevity category as maybe a vinyl siding. You know, am I going to see a return on my investment if I just, you know, plunk down 10, 15 grand to reside my home? Am I going to get back 17,000 in the sales price? Am I going to get back 20? The answer is probably neither. You know, if you have nice clapboard on there and it's well maintained and it's not flaking, you know, it's stained maybe rather than painted, you know, you're probably going to see the same sales price on that home as you would as if it had new vinyl. Depending on the age, of course, there's lots of factors. So you get the idea. You really need to bounce these things off of somebody to get a good idea of how valuable certain features are in your home. So next, understanding that we have to control our bias a little bit, we're going to take this knowledge and we're going to go to the next segment, which is regarding comparative market analyses, setting your home side by side with other homes like it, and comparing and contrasting them to derive a reasonable sales price. We'll see you on the next one. If you like what you're hearing so far, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe button down at the bottom.